Good morning, students. Welcome to Chemistry Online class. Our today lesson is hydrogen. In this session, we will discuss about the introduction, position in periodic table and isotopes of hydrogen. First, our first topic is introduction. Of all the elements, hydrogen is the lightest element. Of all the elements, hydrogen is the lightest element, and then hydrogen atom is the simplest atom. It contains one proton and one electron. And then one more thing is valence electron of the hydrogen and the helium are the elements which directly fill the electrostatic attraction of the nucleus. I am repeating, of all the elements, the valence electron of hydrogen and the helium are the elements which directly fill the electrostatic attraction of the nucleus. And then uncountable number of the hydrogen compounds are available in our day-to-day life. We are crossing enormous number of the hydrogen compounds. The example is water, H2O, carbohydrates and protein, etc. Hydrogen, its atomic number is 1, its electronic configuration is 1s1. Hydrogen atom, it contains one unpaired electron, so it is reactive. So, hydrogen is present in the form of diatomic molecule. That is H2. Our next topic is position in periodic table. Hydrogen, its electronic configuration is 1s1. Group 1 elements, that is alkali metals. Its general valence shell electronic configuration is ns1. Hydrogen 1s1. Alkali metals general outer shell electronic configuration is ns1. So electronic configuration of the hydrogen resembles the general valence shell electronic configuration of the alkali metals. So, some properties of hydrogen resembles the properties of alkali metals. Now, we will discuss the similarities between hydrogen and alkali metals. First one, alkali metals and hydrogen both has the tendency to form unipositive cations. Alkali metals and hydrogen both have the tendency to form the unipositive cation. Alkali metal, it forms the unipositive cations are Na+, K+, Cs+, etc. Hydrogen, its unipositive cation is H+. And then alkali metals, it has the tendency to form halides and then oxides and then sulfides and then peroxides. Like alkali metals, hydrogen also forms the halides, that is HX, oxides, that is H2O, sulfides H2S, peroxides H2O2. Alkali metals, it forms the halides, example NaX, oxides Na2O, sulfides Na2S, peroxides Na2O2. And then it can act as a reducing agent. Like alkali metals, reducing agent. Now, the question is why hydrogen and alkali metals act as a reducing agent. In case any element has the tendency to lose the electron easily, any element it has the tendency to lose the electron easily, it will act as a reducing agent. So hydrogen and alkali metals both act as a reducing agent. And then ionization energy of the alkali metals, it ranges from 377 to 520 kilojoule mole inverse. But the ionization energy of the hydrogen is 1314 kilojoule mole inverse. So we conclude ionization energy of the hydrogen is greater than the ionization energy of the alkali metals. The percentage availability of hydrogen gas in our atmosphere is very very small. Halogens, it has the tendency to form halides. Like halogens, hydrogen, it has the tendency to form hydride ions. How the hydrogen is converted into hydride ion? Hydrogen, it has the tendency to gain one electron and it is converted into hydride ion. Hydrogen, its electronic configuration is 1s1. Hydride ion, that is H-, its electronic configuration is 1s2. The electronic configuration of hydride ion resembles the electronic configuration of the helium. And then electron affinity of the halogen is greater than the electron affinity of the hydrogen. That is the tendency of converting hydrogen into hydride ion is very low as compared to the tendency of converting halogen into halide ion. Let us consider the example. Half mole of the hydrogen, it accepts one electron, it is converted into hydride ion. The del H value is plus 36 kilocalorie mole inverse. Half mole of the bromine, it gains one electron, it is converted into bromide ion. Its del H value is minus 55 kilocalorie mole inverse. In general, electron affinity is the amount of energy released when a neutral gaseous atom accepts an electron to form an ion. Here, the negative charge indicates the energy gets released. Here, the positive charge indicates the absorption of the energy. In general, electron affinity, the concept is amount of energy released. Neutral atom is converted into an ion, but formation of the bromide ion, energy gets released. Formation of the hydride ion, energy gets absorbed. That's why electron affinity of the halogen is greater than the electron affinity of the hydrogen. And then hydrogen, it resembles both alkali metals and halogens. So it is not easy to provide the proper position in the periodic table. Alkali metals, it always shows the plus 1 oxidation state. In most of the hydrogen compounds, hydrogen, it is present in the plus 1 oxidation state. That's why hydrogen is kept in group 1 along with the alkali metals in the latest modern periodic table. It was published by the IUPAC. hydrogen. What is isotopes? Atoms of the same element. It has same atomic number, but a different mass number. Atoms of the same element. It has same atomic number, but a different mass number is called isotopes. Now, isotopes of hydrogen. The first one is protium. 1H1. Protium is also called ordinary hydrogen. Protium is the predominant isotope of the hydrogen. That is, protium is the common form of the hydrogen isotope. And then second one is deuterium. Deuterium, it is represented as 1D2. Deuterium is also called heavy hydrogen. And then third one is tritium. 1T3. Protium, its percentage abundance, that is percentage availability, is 99.985. And then deuterium, its percentage availability is 0.015%. And then tritium, it is present in tracers, that is very small amount. Example, approximately 1 tritium atom per 10 power 18 hydrogen atoms. 1 tritium atom per 10 power 18 hydrogen atoms. Among these three isotopes, tritium, it is the radioactive isotope. Protium, that is 1H1, it contains one proton, one electron, and no neutron. Protium is the only isotope, it has no neutrons. And then deuterium, it contains one proton, one electron, and one neutron. And then tritium, it contains one proton, one electron, and two neutrons. Due to the presence of these isotopes, naturally occurring hydrogen is present in the form of H2, that is hydrogen combines with the hydrogen, and then hydrogen combines with the deuterium, hydrogen combines with the tritium, and then deuterium combines with the deuterium D2, tritium combines with the tritium, and then deuterium combines with the tritium. Due to the presence of isotopes, naturally occurring hydrogen is present in the form of H2, T2, D2, HD, HT, DT, etc. Now, let us discuss the properties of hydrogen, deuterium and tritium molecules. First of all, atomic mass in AMU, that is atomic mass unit, hydrogen 1.008, deuterium 2.014, tritium 3.016, and then number of electrons, protons and neutron, 1 electron, 1 proton and 0 neutron, 1 electron, 1 proton and 1 neutron, 1 electron, 1 proton and 2 neutrons. Nuclear stability, protium and deuterium are the stable ones, but tritium is unstable. That's why it is radioactive. Its half life period T half is equal to 12.3 years. And then molecular hydrogen. Hydrogen, its molecular form is, that is protium, its molecular form is H2, deuterium D2, tritium T2. Abundance, percentage abundance 99.985, 0.015, approximately 10^-16. Molecular mass in AMU, protium 2.016, deuterium 4.028, tritium 6.032. And then melting point and boiling point in Kelvin, protium 13.96/20.30, deuterium 18.73/23.67, tritium 20.62/25.04. And then internuclear distance in picometer, 1 picometer is equal to 10^-12 meter. Protium 74.14, deuterium 74.14, tritium 74.14. And then critical temperature in Kelvin, 33.19 for protium, 38.35 for deuterium, 14.60 for tritium. Now the question is, what is critical temperature? Critical temperature of a substance is defined as the temperature at and above which vapor of the substance cannot be liquefied, no matter how much pressure can be applied. I am repeating, critical temperature of a substance is defined as a temperature at and above which vapor of the substance cannot be converted into liquid, no matter how much pressure is applied. And then enthalpy of dissociation. Enthalpy of dissociation is also called a bound dissociation energy. Now the question is, what is bound dissociation energy? Energy required for the breaking of the bond is called a bound dissociation energy. Protium 435.9 kJ mole inverse. Deuterium 443.4 kJ mole inverse. And then tritium 446.9 kJ mole inverse. We will meet in the next session. Thank you, students. Thank you.